In this video, I'm going to show you how to record your Apple Keynote presentation along with your webcam to create an engaging picture-in-picture video. Hey, it's Mike with more tips and tutorials to help you create great video for your YouTube channel, your video marketing, or online courses. Thank you so much for being here. And if you haven't already, hit that big subscribe button. And don't forget to click the little bell icon so you don't miss a thing. Apple Keynote is slick presentation software, but it's also a powerful, low-cost video creation tool. But what's missing from Keynote, at least at the time of this recording, is the ability to record your webcam while you're recording your presentation. Having your face on camera while you go through your presentation can make your content feel more personal. So in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to record your Keynote presentation along with your webcam, then combine them into a picture-in-picture video with the help of QuickTime Player and iMovie, applications like Keynote that come bundled with a Mac computer. So let's jump into it. So here we are in Keynote, and I have this presentation that I want to record to video, including my webcam or a face cam shot. So let's just take a quick look at this presentation. I'll do that by going up to the top toolbar and selecting play. And we'll step through with the forward arrow key. And you can see my presentation here has animations or builds that come on that reveal the content. And I want to include this in my recorded video. So I'll hit escape to get out of that playback. So the first thing I'm going to do is launch QuickTime Player to make all of this work. So I'll go up to the top menu bar here on the top right, and I'll select Spotlight Search, this magnifying glass icon, and I'll start typing in QuickTime. And there's QuickTime Player in the search results. I'll double click that to launch it. So the first element I want to set up is my webcam or my face cam shot. So to do that, I'm going to go up to the QuickTime menu, and under File, I'm going to select New Movie Recording. And up pops this big window with my webcam shot. I'm going to size this down a little bit here. And so this is the movie recording window, and it has several settings. Beside this big record button, this down arrow, you can select the camera you want to use for the recording. In my case, it's the Logitech C920 webcam. You can also select the microphone. And right now I'm using the Audio-Technica 2020 USB Plus. That's what you're listening to right now. And then here under quality, I have maximum selected. And the reason is I want QuickTime Player to record the maximum resolution of my webcam so that I have some flexibility later on in the process, as you'll see later. So I'll leave that at maximum. And so now this is my face cam or webcam shot. And I'll just size this down. Now, don't worry, it will still record at 1080p full resolution, even though I've shrunk down the window. Okay, so the next thing I want to do is I want to set up a screen recording to record my actual Keynote presentation. So I'm going to go back up to QuickTime Player, and under File, I'll select the only thing I can select, and that's New Screen Recording. And I'll get this screen recording interface here. And under the settings, this down arrow, I can select my microphone. So again, I'm going to select my Audio-Technica 2020 USB Plus as well, same as I had for my webcam shot down here. And this other setting here, this show mouse clicks and recording, what this does is it puts a sort of a graphic highlight in your recorded video wherever you click the mouse. It's handy for tracking the mouse on the screen, but we don't need that for this demo, so we're all set. So now we start recording. So the first recording I'm going to start is my webcam. So you've probably already figured out we're going to have two separate feeds, two separate recordings here, all in QuickTime Player. So the first recording we're going to start is our face cam or webcam. And now we're rolling. And so then we'll start our screen recording. And I press that, and I get this prompt. I can click to record the full screen, or I can drag a selection to record part of the screen. I want the full screen for my presentation, so I'll just click on the screen. and I'm recording. And I know I'm recording because of this little stop button, this little stop icon in the top menu bar. Okay. Now, one other thing I like to do before I get going and record my presentation is, because we have two independent recordings going, we're going to need to put these together and synchronize them later on in the process. So I'm going to use a little film trick, a little trick to make sure that goes a lot smoother. I'm just going to make a little clap. And that should make a nice little spike in the audio track that we'll use to sync these two independent recordings together. You'll see, it'll make more sense later on. Okay, so let's start our actual presentation. So to do that, I'm going to go up to the top toolbar and I'm going to press play, the play button here. And here's my presentation. Now you'll notice you can't see my webcam at all, even on my other monitor. I have two monitors and I can't see my webcam shot. And that's because Keynote takes over the entire graphics system when you go into presentation to play mode. But you have to use play mode if you want to play the different animations or any kind of builds you have in your presentation. So you have to go into play mode. So when you set up your webcam shot, make sure when you actually start recording your presentation that you stay relatively still so that you don't mistakenly duck out of shot while you're giving your presentation. But rest assured, even though you can't see your webcam window, QuickTime Player is recording your webcam shot. So let's just quickly step through this presentation. So in this presentation, we're going to talk about the three phases of video production. The first phase is pre-production. This is the planning phase when you're scouting locations, collecting props, collecting the materials that you're going to need for the next phase, and that is production. This is when you're shooting video or recording sound or doing screen recordings. And then finally, the third phase is post-production. This is when you're bringing together or packaging all of the assets or the elements that you recorded or collected in the production phase to make an engaging experience for your viewer. Okay, so that's my presentation. So to get out of that, I'm going to hit the escape key. And so we're back. And so I'm just going to bring up or tab over to QuickTime to bring back the QuickTime Player. And I'm going to stop my recording. So the first recording I'm going to stop is my webcam. You can see it's still recording. I'll just stop that. And the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to stop my screen recording by clicking the little stop button or stop icon up here in the top menu bar. And up pops my screen recording. I'll just size that down a bit. Let's bring it over here. So here we have our two recordings. We have our screen recording and we have our webcam recording. If I scrub through, you'll see right there, here's our presentation. Starting right there. Okay, so that's there. And just do a quick check of the webcam here, and you can see there's the webcam all the way through. Okay, so the next thing I want to do is save out these files. So I'll save out my webcam shot first. And to do that, I'll just make sure it's selected, and I'll go up to the top menu here in QuickTime Player and select File, Save. And I'll get this save dialog and I'll just type in a name and save this to the desktop. Okay, so that's now saved and I'll just close this webcam file here. And so the next thing we want to do is we want to save out our screen recording. So again, I'll go up to QuickTime Player, File, Save, and I'll save out this file and give it a name. And I'll close this file. And so next, to combine our webcam shot and our screen recording, we're going to jump into iMovie. So here we are in iMovie, and the first thing I'm going to do is import my screen recording and my webcam or face cam recording. So I'll bring up the Finder, and there are my two video files on the desktop. First, I'm going to drag in my screen recording and place it on the timeline here. And then I'm going to go up and I'm going to drag my webcam recording and place it on top of my screen recording clip. So now I can edit these two clips together to create a dynamic presentation style video. But before I can do that, I need to sync up these two video clips because I started the webcam recording before the screen recording. So these videos don't really line up properly as they stand right now on the timeline. So how do I sync these clips? Well, remember when I clapped just before starting my presentation? Well, I'm going to use that clap to line up these two clips. So I'm going to go down to the timeline and I'm going to scrub through my webcam shot here until I find the point where I clap. And here it is. Now notice the big spike in the audio waveform below the clap. Now if you're not seeing the audio waveform on your clips, just head over to the top right of the timeline window and click on the settings button and make sure that beside audio, show waveforms is selected. Okay, so let's head back to my clap here in the webcam shot. And I'm going to zoom in to the timeline here, and I'm going to do that using the keyboard shortcut Command Plus. You can also use Command Minus to zoom back out. And with the playhead placed just before the waveform spike, I'm going to hit the M key to place a marker at that point so I can locate it quickly later on. So now that I've located the clap in my webcam shot, I need to find the corresponding clap in my screen recording clip. So I'll scrub through the timeline again and zoom in accordingly. And here's the corresponding spike in the audio waveform of the screen recording. So again, I'm going to zoom right in using Command Plus, and with the playhead placed just before the waveform spike and with the screen recording clip selected, I'm again going to hit the M key to place a marker at that point. So now I'll line up these two audio spikes as closely as I can with the help of the markers. Trick, a little trick to make sure that goes a lot smoother. I'm just going to make a little clap. And that should make a nice little spike in the audio track that we'll use to sync these two independent recordings together. You'll see it'll make more sense later on. Now that these two clips are synced up, I can edit them together in a variety of ways. Let me just show you a quick example. I'm going to start my video with me on camera, full frame, for the introduction of my presentation. So first, I'll find the point where I actually start the introduction. So now I don't need the sound from the screen recording track for this, so I'm just going to grab the volume control bar here in the waveform, and I'm just going to drag it all the way down to zero just to turn off this sound. It's not deleted, it's just turned off. Okay, I'm going to find the spot where I finish the introduction shot. So let's just quickly step through this presentation. So in this presentation, we're going to talk about the three phases of video production. And that's right here. So now I'm going to make sure my webcam clip here is selected, and then I'm going to right click and select split clip. Now I'll select the part of the clip after the split, and then go up to the toolbar above the preview window and select this first icon, which reveals the video overlay settings. So right now, the selected clip is in cutaway mode, which means it's just covering the clip or the track below it. I'm going to select picture in picture. The clip is now sized down and it overlays the clip below it. So now I can click and drag the webcam clip here and place it where I want to. And I can size it using these little blue corner handles. So let's see what this looks like. So in this presentation, we're going to talk about the three phases of video production. The first phase is pre-production. This is the planning phase. Now that's just a basic example. You can get way more creative with a little bit of imagination. Now this technique takes a few steps, as you could see. Honestly, if you plan on making a lot of these types of videos, you'll save a lot of time if you use software more dedicated to the task. Software like ScreenFlow for the Mac or Camtasia. But if you're budget conscious or just don't want to have to learn more complicated software, this technique may work for you. Well, that's it for this video. I hope you found value in it. And if you want more tips and tutorials for creating great video for your YouTube channel, your video marketing, or online courses, please hit that big subscribe button so you don't miss a thing. And if you have any questions or topics you'd like me to cover, drop those in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.